Every man needs to know PSA. It is one of the things that belong to the core content of general knowledge. Why? Because your life may depend upon it. Yet in my daily work, to my surprise, I often get the question from my patients, what is PSA? Time to make a video about it. My name is Stefan Buntrock. I'm a board-certified urologist and sexologist. PSA is the prostate specific antigen. Its discovery revolutionized the diagnosis and management of prostatic diseases and, first and foremost, of prostate cancer. But PSA is not an easy marker because it is not exclusive to prostate cancer. Benign prostatic disease has an influence on its value as well. So where did it come from? Actually, it almost took 3 decades to establish PSA as a marker for prostate cancer. The 1960s and 70s saw a rapid progression in the field of immunology. It more or less started off with semen. Scientists were looking for antigenic proteins to find out more about infertility. At the same time, there was a lot of interest in finding a biological marker within the seminal fluid, which could be useful for the legal prosecution when women were forced to have sex with men against their will. That was especially important when no sperm could be found with the victim when the perpetrator had a vasectomy or no sperm at all, something which is called azoospermia. A characteristic protein from seminal fluid could serve as forensic evidence. With time, research included the prostate as well, but it took a while until it became clear that the special antigen found in the seminal fluid and in the prostate was one and the same. What we call PSA today is an enzyme that's important for procreation because it liquefies seminal fluid. During the late 70s, there were several research groups around the globe which worked on PSA in relation to prostate cancer. So several scientists have to be credited for the discovery of PSA. But in 1987, it was Thomas Stamey and colleagues who installed PSA as a tumor marker for prostate cancer by publishing a milestone study. They showed that the level of PSA correlates with the advancing stage of prostate cancer and with tumor volume. PSA is the most important marker for the detection of prostate cancer. However, it's not that simple. In most men, the prostate starts to enlarge after the age of 40. Why this happens, we haven't figured out exactly. Anyway, PSA also correlates with prostate volume, meaning that benign enlargement of the organ likewise increases PSA. Another problem is the natural course of prostate cancer. There are still a lot of unanswered questions. There are cancers which are irrelevant because they have a very low potential of harm. Some cancers pose a significant health risk, while others are very aggressive and carry a high risk of a fatal outcome. PSA is very helpful for the detection of prostate cancer, but there is also a risk to find something which would never have caused any harm. In other words, we have a problem by the name of overdetection and consecutively overtreatment if we go by PSA alone. Multiparametric prostate MRI in combination with PSA helps to reduce that risk and is about to become standard of care to avoid unnecessary treatment. This is not a video about PSA screening, so I won't address this controversy. In summary, every man needs to know what PSA is because at one time in his life, he will have to decide whether he wants to be screened for prostate cancer or not. Measuring PSA carries both opportunities and risks. One thing is for sure though, handling PSA professionally requires long years of experience. If you want to know how I interpret PSA values, this video will explain it all. Thanks for watching. Bye bye.